My presentation about the makam indexes, and I borrow a special term from semiology, especially Charles Sanders Peirce. He defines what index is. So, first of all, melody and makam. In Turkish music, there are a direct relationship between melody and makam. So we can call them an inseparable pair or couple. The specific features found in melodies provide the recognition of them as a definite makam or as a certain makam. The particular melodies acquire a certain identity and belonging through the concept of makam. The concept of makam supplies to classifying the melodies with specific properties under a certain name. Okay, Peirce, index concept of Peirce, he has a very special theory of science in terms of semiology or semiotics, and he divide the science in three partition: icon, index, and symbol. This typology emphasizes the different ways in which the sign refers to its object. For example, the icon, by a quality of its own, this is important for me, the index, by real connection to its object, and the symbol, by a habit or rule for its interpretant. Symbol needs an interpretant because, for example, Bahçeşehir University has a special emblem, but I think none of us don't know its meaning because we don't know anything about this symbol. So we can't understand it if we don't anything about a symbol. Okay, what are the indexes, for example? The definition of it: index is a sign that the signifier is directly connected to the signified. For example, all symptoms of illness, echoes, tests, and smells, all kinds of audio or visual recordings, all of them are the indexes. And I think this one also very important for us for music analyzing. All the words denoting direction or place, for example, this, that, here, there, etc. Okay, the conceptual organization of makam. We can divide two main categories. First one is intervallic organization or structure, and the other one is melodic organization, and maybe we can call melodic movement, melodic progression. Some, as you can see, some terms in these categories: whole tone, neutral tone, half tone, tetrachords, pentachords. These are special scale types or units. And also tonic, dominant, subdominant, especially for Western theory and terminology. But in Turkish music, many of time, especially the musicians use these kind of terms. For example, frets or tones, perde. The special beginning of melodies or makam, ağız. In Turkish, especially our historical sources, you can find this term, ağız etmek. Begin to melody or beginning of makam. So, coursing, course or melodic progression, seyir. Go to one sound to other one. Melodic progression, and the finishing or karar, ending. These are the main terms to explain or understand a makam. Literally, makam means place, position or location. We can explain like that. And in traditional terminology for explaining makam, I called it melody-centered model, because it explains the melody's directions or melody's mentality. So three terms are important: ağız, beginning, starting. We can translate like that. Seyir, coursing, melodic movement or progression, and karar, ending, finishing. So maybe makam as position for instrument. For example, we can see on this diagram strings, frets, and fingers. For example, the Hüseyini mod on bağlama. For a musician, Hüseyini makam like this position. When he plays an Hüseyini mod, he uses these strings and these frets, and also these fingers in folk music. So we can understand makam as a position, a special organization of strings, frets, and fingers. The second one, as a place, makam, these two octave on diagram, understand this a traditional sound range of Turkish makam music, mainly. For example, in this system, Hüseyini makam has a special place in traditional system. For example, its final or karar tone is dügah, and it uses segah, çargah, neva frets, and its initial, the beginning or ağaz place is Hüseyini fret. So this is the traditional two octave tone system, and Hüseyini has a special place in this system. So makam, we can understand here, also a special place. It defines a special place of any makam. We can use two different explaining models, especially in modernization period of Turkey. The scale-centered approach and its terminology used began to use for explaining makams. As you know, intervals, scales, major, minor, tetrachords, tonic, dominant, degree, that kind of terms used to explain for makam. But in traditional explaining model, I called it melody-centered approach. Perde, name means melody. Ağaz, initial or beginning, that kind of terms. These are different from the other one. So how can I use semiology for explain melodic indexes to make a distinction from makams? A melody with specific features signifies a certain makam. So some makams have the same scales, but they have different names. If a makam has a different name, it means its melodies are different from the others. So, what are the main differences between these kind of makams? They use the same scale, but they have different names. According to today's makam theory, a makam is generally known with its special scale, its tonic and dominant degrees, and its transitory final degrees, middle stops. But for these kind of makams, these criteria are inadequate for the makams mentioned. Okay. So my main approach to search for the beginning styles of melodies and to understand their roles on making distinction between makams. some basic questions. For example, with which fret the melody begins and directs to? And which fret is the central tone in melodic orientation? And is there any relationship between the makam names and the beginning layers of the scale which melody begins? My purpose, analyzing the roles and functions of the beginnings of the makam melodies for doing makam distinctions. So, I use a sample and try to develop a method, choosing the makams with different names but the same scale, and also choosing the melodies that their initial layers and tonal centers are different. My sample include two different kind of makam groups. First of all, first one is Hüseyini group. In traditional sources, it include these intervals: Mücennep, Mücennep, Tanini, Tanini. Mücennep means a kind of neutral tone. So I use three structures. First one is Nevruz. Today we called it Uşşak tetrachord, a tetrachord. Hüseyini is a pentachord, and Muhayyer is an octachord. And the other one is Hijaz group. In traditional historical sources also codified this group, Mücennep Tanini, Mücennep Tanini. But today we can understand especially the middle Tanini a little larger. Today we use it larger type. So Hijaz tetrachord, it's a kind of similar category in Nevruz, with Nevruz. Uzal pentachord, this is also a similar category with Hüseyini. And the Nühüft, and today we call it Nevaşiran, but I have some historical knowledge about this changing. I use this time for the name of that kind of melodies, Nühüft, okay. So you can see on this diagram what are the scales or sounds of these categories: Hüseyini grubu and Hijaz grubu, or Hüseyini group or Hijaz group. As you see, Nevruz and Hijaz are the tetrachords, and Hüseyini and Uzal are the pentachords, and the others are the octachords. So I use my our folk music repertoire. I make a search for melodies and try to classify them in these tetrachordal, pentachordal, or octachordal structures. So when we look the melodies, for example, all of them, these examples, folk songs. For Nevruz, I show this circle the beginning center of the melodies. Okay, the melody develop or of this fret, neva fret. This one is called, traditional name is neva fret, and the melodies begins with this fret. But you can see some different beginning variations. But the central position of the note can change in the beginning sections. We can look the other examples. For example, Hijaz makamı. This is also a tetrachord. And also in tradition, Hijaz, the melodies belong to Hijaz makamı, begins with the neva fret or around it. So you can see also the central position of this note in these examples. The other one for Hüseyini, this time melodies begins with Hüseyini fret or it's around, okay. But it has the central position for beginning section of these melodies. Uzal, the same category as a pentachord. Also, these kind of melodies belong to Uzal repertoire, begins with Hüseyini fret also. This is the fifth tone of the pentachord, and then goes down to the final tone. And the other category, muhayyer, it belongs to Hüseyini group. This time we can see in muhayyer makamı, these melodies begins with muhayyer fret. So this is the eighth tone of the octachord. Octave tone of octachord. So this time you can see the central position or central place is muhayyer fret. And the last example for nühüft. Nühüft belongs to Hijaz group and it's an octachord. The melodies which belong to Hijaz group begins with muhayyer in Hijaz group. So there are two categories and three different samples use the same patterns for central tone or melodic index for makam. This is a generalization of these examples. The role of steps and intervals determining the beginning centers. For example, please look the Nevruz and Hijaz. Melodies begins the lower step and goes to Neva fret, ascending movement. Okay. So the central position of this tetrachord, Neva fret, is very clear to understand. It has a central position for beginning of makam. So this similarity also correct for Hüseyini and Uzzal for their categories. Why? Because this time the central position or central tone is Hüseyini fret. But we know Hüseyini grubu and Hijaz grubu has different interval organization. But their beginning strategies are the same in these categories. Tetrachordal, pentachordal or octachordal categories. And also muhayyer and nühüft, we can see the central position of muhayyer fret. Both these makams. And I divide two categories, ascending ones and descending ones, to the central note. Begin with, for example, higher tone, but directs to central tone. Also, you can see Nevruz and Hijaz for Nevruz and Hijaz makams. For example, melody begins with Hüseyini fret, but directly goes to Neva fret. And it's like a direction, okay? It's like an arrow to show a direction. And my findings about these analyses, from this analyze, all analyzed samples of the melodies have the specific positions and a central tone in beginning sections. For Nevruz and Hijaz tetrachords, the highest tone of the tetrachord is the beginning location and the central tone is Neva. It's very clear. For Hüseyini and Uzzal pentachords, the highest tone of the pentachord is the beginning place and the central tone is Hüseyini for these melodies. And the last category, for Muhayyer and Nühüft octachords, the highest tone of the octachord is the beginning place and the central tone this time is muhayyer. Model indexes, I use index term as you know. Model indexes of Nevruz and Hijaz modes. For example, directly beginning with Neva in both. Ascending step from Chargah to Neva in Nevruz, from Hijaz to Neva in Hijaz. These are melodic indexes show a makam, and it's it has a special role or function to making model distinctions. Another one, ascending steps from Segah via Chargah to Neva in Nevruz, from Dikkürdi or Lowd Segah, Lower Segah, via Hijaz to Neva in Hijaz. Ascending fort from Dugah to Neva. Descending stem from Hüseyni to Neva in Bod. The analyzers show these kind of examples clearly. These are not interpretations. So we can see also on notations these categories for Nevruz and Hijaz. Both categories has same melodic directions or melodic signifyings to central tone, for central tone. The other categories also has the same qualities or same specialties, features. And this is the last examples for Muhayyer and Nühüft. And my conclusion, as makam indexes, beginnings and beginning sections are very important analyzing material for understanding the makam distinctions, especially using the same scale. So, also notations show all these makams for the first stuff, Nevruz, Hüseyni and Muhayyer, for example, use the same scale. But why we called these makams for different names or with different names? So the main answer for this question, the beginning positions or beginning locations of these melodies are very important to understand this distinction or separation. Thank you very much. So a makam has many different features and includes some different functional topics for understand a makam. My main purpose in this presentation to show or try to show a beginning sections has a special role, especially makams for using the same scale. Tahir also in this category, but main distinction criteria of Muhayyer and Tahir, their middle stops or temporary final tones. For example, melody begins the higher tones of scale and goes down to the first final stop on Hüseyni. If a mode like this, we called it Muhayyer. But if it finals on temporarily on Neva fret, this time our traditional musicians and theoreticians called or classified this melody in Tahir makam. But we need more historical searches on Turkish musical treatises. Is it Muhayyer or Tahir? Maybe all of them is Muhayyer, I don't know, or I am not sure. But today, this distinction is a rule. If melody uses Hüseyni fret as a temporarily final tone, it's Muhayyer. If Neva, it's Tahir. This is also another criterion for to make this kind of distinctions.
So would it be true to think that there is a hierarchical classification? Like you start with a classification based on the beginnings first. So you make groups based on the beginnings. So Muayyer and Tahir would fit in one group.
Maybe.
And then further, you can look at the middle stops. So in a decision, hierarchical decision. So at the first step, you look at the beginnings. And then at the second step, you look at the ending, the middle ending.
That's right. Oh, yes. Yes.
So maybe there is a hierarchical decision about manners.
That's right. Thank you too. Thank you very much.